On the news tonight, President Buhari to visit Borno State for appraisal of security situation in the Northeast. House of Representatives screened President Buhari nominee Farouk Yahya for position of Chief of Army Staff. Plus, NBC orders broadcasting stations to stop further use of Twitter in line with suspension by the Nigerian government. Details and more in just a moment. A very good evening to you and welcome to the news. I am Justina Etem. We begin with security, where President Muhammadu Buhari will arrive in Maiduguri on Thursday, the 17th of June 2021, for a one-day working visit to Borno State. Governor of the state, Babagana Zulum, who disclosed this to journalists, noted that the president would be appraising the security situation in the Northeast. He says during the visit, President Muhammadu Buhari will inaugurate the 4,000 houses which were part of the federal government's housing project, as well as some local government projects executed by the state government. The House of Representatives Committee on Army and Defense has screened President Muhammadu Buhari's nominee, Major General Farouk Yahya, for the position of Chief of Army Staff. Speaker of the House of Representatives, Femi Gbajabiamila, read a letter from President Buhari during plenary seeking confirmation of Farouk Yahya as the Chief of Army Staff. Chairman of the Committee on Defense, Babajimi Benson, says the exercise was coming at a time when the country is battling various security challenges, urging the nominee to ensure that he finds a lasting solution to the problem of insecurity. Meanwhile, a total of 161 members of the 9 voluntary security outfit have been trained and inaugurated into the Niger State Special Vigilante Corps to complement the efforts of other security agencies in stemming insecurity and maintaining law and order in the state. Niger State Governor Abubakar Sani Bello, who inaugurated the Special Vigilante Corps, handed over 10 Toyota pickup vans and 20 motorcycles to ease their task. Hussaina Musa reports.
The Niger State Special Vigilante Corps, which comprised of 9 voluntary security outfits, were harmonized after a series of negotiations to checkmate the activities of thugs and other criminal elements in their communities. The Special Vigilante Corps, who were presented appointment letters by the state government, were trained for 2 weeks at the police training school and are expected to assist in curbing youth restiveness to complement conventional security agencies. To enhance effective service delivery, the Vigilante Corps were supported with 20 motorcycles and 10 pickup vans.
The threat in Mina is different from the threat outside. These ones, these special vigilantes you are seeing, you recall that about a month ago, almost on daily basis, you have youth coming out with cutlasses, fighting themselves. The special vigilante corps you see here is to maintain law and order with the police in Mina. They are to complement the efforts of the police so that this menace, this nonsense happening with Mina should stop immediately so that people can move freely.
Governor Abubakar Sani Bello urged the Vigilante Corps to carry out their responsibilities within the confines of the law, disclosing that the state government will take responsibility of members in case of any casualty in the line of duty. Imena Hussaina Musa, NT News.
In a related development, the Nigerian Navy is to move its special boat service to Kano. Chief of Policy and Plans, Rear Admiral Christian Ezekobe, disclosed this when he led a delegation on a courtesy visit to Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje at the government house. Abdullahi Mustafa has the reports.
The 10-man delegation came to Kano at the instance of the Chief of Naval Staff, Vice Admiral Awol Zubairu Gambo. Among messages brought, leader of the delegation and Naval Chief of Policy and Plans, Rear Admiral Christian Ezekobe, stated, are a concluded plan to establish a Nigerian Navy Comprehensive Secondary School in Kano.
Most Nigerians do not know that the number one special forces in the country today is domiciled with the Navy. We have the Nigerian Navy Special Boat Service. They are the most potent in Nigeria today. The Army acknowledges that, and the Air Force acknowledges that. They are trained by the American SEALs and the British Special Boat Services. So that component of their training that has to do with desert warfare could be moved to Kano State.
He also told the governor that the Naval Officers' Wives Association is planning to establish a 200-bedded hospital for less privileged in Kano. Governor Abdullahi Umar Ganduje, while expressing gratitude to the Navy High Command for the developments brought to Kano, assured of support towards actualization of the project and successful conduct of the conference. In Kano, Abdullahi Mustafa, NTA News.
In compliance with the federal government's suspension of Twitter operations due to the persistent use of the platform for activities that are capable of undermining the corporate existence of Nigeria, all broadcasting stations are thereby directed to suspend Twitter operations patronage and deinstall all such handles from their programming. A statement signed by the Zonal Director, National Broadcasting Commission, Henry Asaba, for the Acting Director General states that Section 2, Subsection 1 of the NBC Act entrusts the Commission with a responsibility to ensure strict adherence to national laws, rules, and regulations. Therefore, it is unpatriotic to patronize the suspended Twitter as its source of information. The release further indicates that the broadcast code requires broadcasters to be mindful of materials that may cause disaffection and incite rift in the society in the usage of user-generated content. Let's take a quick break for now. We'll be back shortly with more reports. Please stay with us.
Everyday events occur, and as they occur, we bring them to you anywhere you are. News updates showing on your channel of choice, NTA Channel 9 Calabar, afford you opportunity to get it fresh, hot, and loaded. 3 minutes newscast of headline story every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. You can't afford to miss it. It is the news update on NTA Calabar, the station for the people.
Welcome back to the rest of the news. The Controller General of Corrections, Haliru Nababa, has approved the redeployment of 7 Deputy Controllers General of Corrections as part of strategies to reposition the Nigerian Correctional Service for better service delivery. Those affected in the new posting are DCG Tunde Ladipo, moved from non-custodial to health and welfare. DCG Sylvester Nwakuche, who hitherto was in charge of training and staff development, now takes over as DCG non-custodial. Others are Emilia Oputa Adaobi, DCG covering duty for training and staff development; Uche Nwobi, DCG covering duty, inmates training and productivity; Akinji Jonwin Tose, DCG covering duty for works and logistics; Amadu Adamu, DCG covering duty, human resources; Amadu Magaji, DCG covering duty for finance and account. In a statement by the Service Public Relations Officer, Francis Enobore, the posting is geared towards injecting new ideas into management of the service to address emerging challenges and meet the huge expectations of the public, particularly in the implementation of the Nigeria Correctional Service Act 2019. And on politics, it appears that the defection of Cross River State Governor Ben Ayade to the governing All Progressives Congress has caused the People's Democratic Party in the state to stage a welcome rally in Calabar to regain its relevance. Attended by the leadership of the party, led by its national chairman, Uche Secondus, the party inaugurated its new annex secretariat and formally received a former governor of the state, Mr. Donald Duke, to its fold. Aretindem was there.
The rally, also attended by former Senate President Bukola Saraki, among other party stalwarts, past and present governors in the country, was a time to declare the party's determination to take over the reins of power in Cross River State.
And so, we have come on simple assignment to declare the new office, the new edifice of PDP in Calabar open. PDP and the people of Kurosima have spoken.
Kurosima State is PDP, PDP is Kurosima State, and that is where we are. PDP!
In a joyous mood, party faithful received the former governor of the state, Donald Duke, who publicly declared his loyalty to the party.
No matter what differences you have in a family, when your house is threatened, you come back.
The party in the state also presented to supporters and party faithful the executive members of the Keteka committee, as well as chapter chairmen across the state. In Calabar, Arut Ndem, NTA News.
And on health, Nigeria is expecting additional 3.92 million doses of the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, latest in early August. Executive Director, National Primary Healthcare Development Agency, Dr. Faisal Shuaib, disclosed this to journalists in Abuja, but did not give the exact date as to when the country will take delivery of the vaccines. He stated that while efforts to ensure the supply of safe and effective COVID-19 vaccines were ongoing, the Presidential Steering Committee would hold its planned meeting with stakeholders in the South-South region and the larger communities of COVID-19 vaccination on the course of the week. Engaging in horticulture or picking up unique flowers for environmental beautification could be a great way to create one's own oasis, as plants generally keeps the environment clean by providing abundant supply of oxygen. As such, protection and care are required for their growth, just as Udwap Etem in this special report looks at the benefits of flowers in environment and their adaptation to climate change.
A flower, sometimes known as a bloom or blossom, is the reproductive structure found in flowering plants and are beneficial to the environment. This is because flowers are known to usually produce much of the oxygen in the atmosphere through the process of photosynthesis. Studies have routinely proven that with an increase in the number of plants, there is an improvement in air quality. So it is with this general acceptability that planting flowers can be a great way to make the environment a beautiful place.
My name is Rose. I'm also a part of what you call flower, because we have a species of rose, a species of flower called rose flower. So that alone should make you understand how I love flowers. This flower here is also a beautiful one, and I love it because it helps to beautify this environment.
Basically, as you can see, it's beautiful. Okay, that actually, I will start with that. Flowers are very beautiful in areas. So having a good garden of flowers in your compound or vicinity is very nice. And also, flowers help in the cleansing of the oxygen. You know, the climate is changing every day, so you need more flowers around you to help you breathe better, you know, your oxygen. And there are some flowers that actually help in scaring some animals away, like snakes and some reptiles like that. And my last point would be that flowers that help, you know, in the human system as herbs. Some specialists use them to create herbs.
In the case of artificial flowers, Nigerians continue to appreciate them as gifts and for their beauty, just like a floral bouquet usually carried by a bride during a wedding ceremony. These are attractive to the eyes while also adding color to events. But as the world experiences climate change, these experts say natural flowers have been adapted by expanding into new territories while shifting their breeding seasons. This, he adds, calls for the protection of the plants.
The ornamentals, of course, you know, they help to beautify our environment. not just that, much more to that. They produce oxygen, which we breathe, and absorb carbon four oxide, which goes to increase the temperature, that is, they destroy the ozone layer and therefore increase the temperature of the earth. So my advice is that we should plant more flowers around our environment and irrigate them, water them when there is no rain, so that they can grow well and help us to purify our environment.
As man continues to conquer his environment, experts advise that flowers, which help to heal common cold, improve mood and memory, aid relaxation, as well as increase energy, should be an integral of man's immediate environment at all times. In Calabar, Uduak Etam, NTN News.
And on sports, for more on Euro 2020, let's join Tamara Ebiwe.
Portugal and Juventus forward Cristiano Ronaldo was the center of attraction as he scored a brace in the 87th and 92nd minutes in their 0-3 defeat of Hungary, making him the first player to appear at five men's European championships. He also became the tournament's top scorer with 11 goals. In other fixtures, France outscored Germany 0-1 to begin their campaign on the right foot. In today's matches, Finland takes on Russia in their second group game as Turkey squares up against Wales. Italy are up against Switzerland later tonight. Away from Euro 2020, Nigeria Super Falcons will trade tackles with hosts USA in their last game of the Women's National Team WNT Summer Series. Head coach Randy Wardrum says they will compete to the best of their ability.
I think we all know and respect the U.S. and what they bring to women's football. But I would expect our players to do nothing short of what they did the first two games. That's to compete to the best of our ability all the way to the very end. And like I said, I think we will go in, we'll be confident in the way we want to play, and we'll certainly be doing our best.
The Super Falcons hope to pick maximum points against USA. With sports updates, Tamara Ebiwe, NTA News.
And still on sports, with less than 37 days to the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, Nigerian athletes have intensified training to win medals. In the special report, correspondent Clement Olorun-Toba assesses Nigeria's chances in the athletics.
As the world awaits the official opening ceremony of the Tokyo 2020 Olympics in Japan on the 23rd of July 2021, one prominent sport that always steals the show is athletics. Nigeria made her debut at an Olympic Games in 1952 in Finland and her future 16 times. Nigeria has so far recorded 25 medals in 16 Olympics, with athletics as a sport producing 13 medals. In athletics, the athlete achieves qualifying standard by qualifying time or by world ranking, whichever way. The 2020 Tokyo Olympics will not be an exception. Preparations for better outing have so far commenced, as athletes are already in camp for those that have qualified, while those that have not qualified still have another chance.
What is left for the team?
The relays. Yes, Nigerians are yet to qualify for the relays, which is a 4x1, 4x4. And we're sure we'll be picking a ticket, hopefully, this week.
The caliber of athletes in camp right now, they are very, very young. And I can tell you, authoritatively, they are athletes for the future, and my expectation for them is very high. I know they will go there and make a very, very good impression.
Nigerian athletes will be taking part in field and track events, which include 100 meters, 200 meters, 100 meters hurdles, 200 meters hurdles, 400 meters, men's short puts, women's long jump, women's triple jump, and women's hammer throw.
Everything is going on well, the training is going on, and we are getting ready for the national trials. That is the last qualification.
As the athletes go for the national trials this Thursday, Nigerians will be hoping for a better outing from the athletes to surpass their previous records. In Abuja, Clement Olorun-Toba, NT News.
And with that sports update, we've come to the end of the news. And now a review of the top stories. President Muhammadu Buhari will visit Borno State tomorrow for appraisal of security situation in the northeast. The House of Representatives has screened President Buhari's nominee, Farouk Yahya, for the position of Chief of Army Staff. You also heard in the news that the National Broadcasting Commission has ordered broadcasting stations to stop further use of Twitter in line with its suspension by the Nigerian government. And that's it on the news. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful time.